In this video, I'm going to show how to create a trace without mask, which is necessary if you are going to increase its current carrying capacity by thinning. Generally, in DipTrace PCB layout module, mask layer always exists by default, but any shapes placed on that layer will eliminate mask within the shape boundaries and expose copper. So to get a trace without mask, we need to place a polyline right over the trace on the corresponding mask layer. Our trace is located on the bottom layer, so first of all we should select Bottom Mask Layer. Next, press Place Shape button on the drawing toolbar and select a polyline shape. Now let's place a polyline following the bands of the trace. Left-click at the starting point and begin drawing. Left-click to anchor points and change the angle of the line. When done, right-click at the endpoint and select Enter. The polyline is not visible now because of the priority rules and display order of the layers. To see the polyline on the bottom mask layer, you should hide the bottom layer by removing a blue check mark next to this layer. We have to edit our polyline to make it a bit wider than the trace. I'll hover over the trace to double check its width first. It's about 0.02 inches. For convenience, we are going to disable trace selection to be able to edit our polyline while keeping the trace visible. So go to Objects tab, pick Selection Only from the drop-down, and untick Traces. Now left-click on the polyline to select it and enable editing. Note that Properties tab has opened upon selection. We can set a new line width value right here. Since the trace is 0.02 inches wide, let's make the polyline 0.04 inches. If you need to change the position of the polyline, just click on a node and drag it. Note that the same principle is also applicable to the situations when you need to expose copper pores, but in that case, it is advisable to place filled rectangles on the mask layer.